Hello everyone and welcome back. In this video, we will learn how to create a happy glass cave. This is the second part of how to create a happy glass cave. And if you haven't watched the first part, you can get the link from the top right corner or you can find the link in the description. Now let's analyze what we have to create in this game. In the game, when we press the left mouse button, we create a line and we have to guide the water so that the glass can be happy. And we want to make him happy so that we can clear the level. Now let's start creating this game. Now let's start creating the actual level. I will create a new scene and I will name it game scene and I will save it in the scene folder. I will rename the sample scene to main menu. Now add both the scene to the build setting. I will go on file, then build setting. I will drag and drop the main menu scene as well as the game scene. Now let's make some prefab. I will make water game object as well as the water tap game object a prefab so that we can use this in the next scene. Now open the game scene. I will drag and drop the background sprite prefab and I will drag and drop the water tap prefab. Now let's create a 2D sprite game object for the obstacle and I will assign the rectangular sprite to it and I will align it. I will drag and drop our sad glass. I will create an empty game object and I will name it obstacle and I will drag and drop these two obstacles inside that. I will add box collider to the obstacle. Now let's test if all the thing is correctly working or not. Everything is working fine. Now first of all go to the water tap game object and change the is main menu variable to false. And we have to write some code in the water tap glass. Let's create a new game object and I will name it manager. I will reset the transform. I will create a new script for this manager game object. Drag and drop the manager script on manager game object and open the script in editor. Now inside the manager class, let's create a new variable. I will name it is started. And if this bool variable is true, we will start the game. Now we have to take the reference of the manager class in this script. For that, I will create a new variable. I will name it GM. I will take the reference of that class in the start. And in the update, if is started bool variable is false, we will just return from the update. Now we have to write the functionality to draw a line. This is a beginner friendly tutorial and I have found a very good package for this. And this is actually free. You can go to Unity Asset Store and you have to search 2D Polygon Line Collider. I will open the first one. And I will import this in our project. Hit on import. This is a very good package and it is easy to use. All the lines are commented as well. I will also write the review as well. This is the folder of the asset. And this asset comes with two example scenes, which you can see. But we will not open this. I will create an empty game object and I will name it line holder. I will add the line factory script to it. And in the first field, I will drag and drop the line prefab, which is under the prefab folder. And inside the line parent transform, I will drag and drop the line holder transform. I will change the rigid body type to dynamic and I will change the on create to on release. I have done this because when I release the left mouse button, I want to change the rigid body to dynamic. And for the line life, let's create an empty canvas. I will create a new image inside this canvas. I will scale it down and change the color to black. I will create a new image inside this image and I will change the color to green. And I will change the image type to filled. And I want the fill method to be horizontal. Now drag and drop this image on line life field. Change these two variables to true. We have to change some setting on the line prefab as well. Now open the line prefab. I will increase the width of the line. I will reduce the max point to 50. Because of this asset, this was quite easy. Now this is looking good. Now let's create the functionality to show the game end screen. I will create a variable and I will name it isGameAndStarted. This is a bool type and I will take the reference of the LineFactory class. We will do that using findObject of type. And inside the update, if the hasGameStarted variable of the LineFactory class is true and sGameAndStarted is false, we will call a method. Let's create that method and I will name that method startEndScreen. I will invoke this method after certain interval of time. And inside the startEndScreen method, I will make the gameEndScreen game object to true. First of all, let's create that game object. I will create a gameEndCanvas game object variable and inside the startEndScreen method, I will change it to true. And inside the update method, I will set it to false so that we will not see this game object on the screen. And inside the update, I will change the isGameAndStarted variable to true so that this line of code will run only once. Now inside the GlassLine class, if hit count is greater than 0, let's show the star count as well. For that, we have to create the text field in the manager script. Let's go to the manager script. To use text in our script, we have to import UnityEngine.ui. We will use the TextMaxPro text element and I will name it StarText. Let's go to the GlassLine class. First of all, we have to take the reference of the manager script. We will do that using findObject of type in the start method. First of all, we have to create an int variable in the manager class and if hit count is greater than 80, we will set the star count to 3. Else if hit count is greater than 70, we will change it to 2. Else we will change it to 1. Now inside the manager script, let's create a variable to show if the game is cleared or not. And inside the GlassLine class, if the hit count is greater than 60, we will change the game clear variable to true. Else we will change it to false. And if the game is not clear, user cannot go to the next level. Let's go to the manager script and create a game object variable. I will name it load next level. So inside the start and screen method, and if the game is not clear, we will hide the load next level button. For the readability, I will rename it to load next level button. Save it. Let's go to Unity. Now let's create game and canvas. Create an empty canvas and I will name it game and canvas. Inside the canvas, I will create a panel. After that, I will create an empty game object and I will create two buttons. The first button will load the next level and the second button will restart the scene. I will change the image of the button and I will create a TextMaxPro text. I will move it up and I will rename it to star. I will duplicate it and in the text I will write 3. Let's go to the manager script and I will drag and drop the game and canvas game object. And I will drag and drop the star text to the star text field. I will drag and drop the load next level button to the load next level button field. I will change the current scene to 1. Inside the manager script, I have created a current scene variable and we will load the next scene or restart the scene depending upon this current scene variable. Let's create a new script and I will name it our screen manager. Open the script in editor. In the awake method, we don't want this game object to destroy when we load the next scene. So in the awake method, we will write don't destroy game object. Now let's create a new method to load the next scene. And if the scene number is not provided, we will load the scene at the index 0. Save the script. Now let's create few variable in the manager class. I will name this method loadNextScene. And inside this method, we will call loadScene method of our scene manager class. We will loadNextScene by adding +1 to the current scene. And I have also created a restartScene method which will restart the current scene. If we lose or the glass is not happy, we have to restart the current scene. Now let's quickly head over to Unity. And when load next level button is clicked, we will call the load next scene method of the manager class. And when the restart button is clicked, we will call the restart scene method of the manager class. Now let's go to main menu scene. and inside this create a new game object. I will name it scene manager and drag and drop our scene manager script to this game object, and when the start button is clicked we will load the next scene. Now get back to the game scene 1 and I will duplicate it to create a new scene. This will be the level 2 of our game. Open the level 2 scene, and the level 2 is different from the level 1. I will quickly change the obstacle position so that it will look like the level 2 of the original game. I will change the water tap position and rotate it. I will scale the obstacle and move it. Now it is looking like a level 2 scene of the original game. Now the water particle have to move to the left hand side. For that we have to add some functionality to the script. Open the water tap script. Let's create a vector 2 variable and I will name it particle flow direction, and the particle will flow depending upon this direction. And after the line, when we instantiate the water game object, I will simply add force to the rigid body component. Now let's get back to Unity and I want to add the force in the negative x direction. Let's test the application. Congratulations, we have done it. We have created a playable game and the glass is happy, and because of that I can go to the next level. Let's go to the glass line class, and if manager is null we will simply return. We will run this line of code only if the game manager is not null. Write the same thing in here. Now head over to Unity and start the main menu scene. Let's test the application from the start. Great, the main menu is looking great. Now I will click on start to start the game. And I will win the game and loot the next level. Both of the level are working correctly. Glass look really happy. Now in the real game, when we start drawing the line, we actually see a pencil sprite which move along with our mouse position. Now let's create that functionality and I will create a list of vector 2 type. I will name it point, not audio listener. I will create a list. For the list we have to use namespace system.collection.generic. Let's create one more variable. I will name it hasGameStarted, which is of bool type. And if the mouse button is pressed, we will set it to true. And when we release the mouse button, we will set it to false. To create a pencil sprite, we will create a pencil variable. And when the game starts, we will simply show the pencil game object. And I will set the last position of the point list to the pencil transform position. And inside the line class, when we set the position to the line renderer, we will also provide the value to the point. And when we release the mouse button, we will change the hasGameStarted variable to false. And we will hide the pencil game object. I haven't created a pencil sprite, so let's create something which look almost similar to the pencil. I will drag and drop this game object on the pencil field in the manager. I will hide the pencil game object. Now let's start the game. Now we can see the pencil when we draw the line. Game is complete. Now you can easily add different functionality to it. Let's create this pencil as a prefab and open the game scene 1. I will drag and drop this pencil game object in the manager script. Now let's start the main menu scene and let's play what we have created till now. Now this is a happy glass. Be happy and spread happiness. Congratulations and smile because you have created a game. And if you have learned anything from this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to this channel for more updates. See you in the next video.
Now this is a happy class.